Also tonight, Missouri offenders on parole or probation are getting gift cards and passes to local attractions as rewards for good behavior.
The state auditor is now investigating. She talked to Fox Files investigator Chris Hayes about what she is calling an alarming lack of answers.
Missouri State Auditor Nicole Galloway is now investigating the state's Department of Corrections. She wants to find out whether you're paying to give gifts to offenders after they're released from prison.
When sheriffs are asking these questions from the Department of Corrections and not getting answers, that is very concerning because they're the front lines of dealing with these offenders.
Fox 2's recent Crumbling Corrections reports have featured concerns from sheriffs across Missouri.
Just let our community members know what is really going on behind the scenes.
Like a probation and parole incentive behavior matrix tool. The Department of Corrections website says it was established after a 2017 task force meeting with sheriffs, crime victims, and prosecutors to fight violent crime rates and prison overcrowding. That meeting reportedly led to this outline of possible rewards, like a gift card, pass to a local attraction, a transportation voucher. Auditor Galloway is now asking,
how are they accounting for those? How many have been passed out? Who is getting them? And, you know, are there boundaries or restrictions on how those are handed out to offenders? There's a potential of taxpayer dollars being utilized for this incentive program, and we want to get to the bottom of it.
The Department of Corrections website says taxpayer dollars are not used to pay for incentives.
They need to show us. You know, you can say that, but we want to see the documentation. We want to understand how the program is administered. And are there taxpayer-funded staff that's taking their time to administer this program?
As far as giving gift cards to offenders, the Missouri Department of Corrections says most incentives have no monetary value, and that, quote, using reinforcements in response to positive behavior is a more effective motivator than only using sanctions in response to poor behavior. A correction spokesperson today said they've already answered the auditor, reporting incentives have only cost $1,200, paid for by inmate funds, not tax dollars, and the corrections officers don't hand out any rewards. Rather, they come from charitable groups. Galloway said we could hear her investigative results as early as next week. For the Fox Files, I'm Chris Hayes.